The Coalition of Planets was ultimately the progenitor to the Federation. It is ironic to consider that the formation of the Coalition of Planets to be the result of only two Alpha Quadrant powers, that of the United Earth and the Romulan Star Empire. While there is enough evidence to conclude that the Coalition was forming anyway, Romulan interference in Alpha and Beta Quadrant affairs would speed up the process tenfold. The Coalition is most notable for the signatories of humans, Vulcans, Andorians, and Tellarites. Indeed, these would be considered the founding members of the Federation. But it's interesting to note that the dignitaries from Rigel, Denobula, and Corridon were also present. It makes me wonder why these powers weren't also the founding members of the Federation. The Coalition of Planets was for self-defense, so when the Earth-Romulan War began, I'm not completely sure why Rigel, Denobula, and Corridon didn't step up to assist in defense. And if they did, why they weren't included in the founding of the Federation at the conclusion of the war. Or if membership was offered at the time, why they opted not to join. There may be Alpha canon out there that explains this, but I sincerely wasn't able to really find anything. Though, I'm sure it's quite obviously somewhere and it's just so pointed out, my comment section will be inundated about how I suck at life and my job, but for me, I just couldn't find anything. When looking at how the Coalition formed, it's important to remember a few things. When humans first achieved warp drive and began exploring the galaxy, most other galactic powers had already been established. So, interestingly enough, while humanity may have been the glue that brought the powers together, it was probably more because humans were the new kid on the block and thus had not built up any history that would cause animosity. So when the Romulans redoubled their efforts to cause derision between the Alpha and Beta Quadrant powers, humanity took up the role of diplomat. Those same powers that were at each other's throat had little reason to believe any inherent bias existed in the humans themselves. When Starfleet said they wanted to help, there was no reason to believe that they didn't want to help. Though the ultimate event that would bring everyone together would be the Babel Crisis. A complete breakdown of the Babel Crisis will be done in another video, but ultimately it was an attempt by the Romulan Star Empire to create war between the Alpha and Beta Quadrant powers. Realizing a malevolent force was at work, though never identifying the Romulans specifically, the NX-01 Enterprise under Jonathan Archer would bring together a fleet of humans, Vulcans, Andorians, and Tellarites. It would be the very first step towards a lasting peace, and ultimately, one of the strongest alliances the galaxy would ever see. The United Earth would use this as an example during its continued attempt to create peace and ally with other governments. The Romulan Star Empire would inadvertently further the need to reinforce the Coalition and push the species even further together through attempts to break them apart. Ironically, the only entity that came close to destroying the Coalition was that of other humans. A group by the name of Terra Prime, a xenophobic isolationist group, would threaten to destroy Starfleet Command during these talks to form the Coalition. They would guarantee the safety of any alien species that left the Sol system within the next 24 hours. But after that, Starfleet would be destroyed if any alien remained on Earth. The group would show a human Vulcan baby as the ultimate betrayal of human purity. Thankfully, Terra Prime would be stopped by Jonathan Archer and the crew of the NX-01 Enterprise. But the damage would be done as many in the Coalition would believe that humanity was not ready to bring the galactic powers together. However, the death of the human Vulcan baby, Elizabeth, would be used as a unifying event that would bring the powers back to the table and cement the alliance. The Coalition would continue to work together and provide common defense and would be the ultimate deciding factor in the Earth-Romulan War. The resounding defeat of the Romulans would bring the four founding members together in a stronger bond, creating the Federation. An organization that would single-handedly change not only galactic events in the Alpha and Beta Quadrants, but also have a resounding and everlasting effect in the Delta and Gamma Quadrant. Stay tuned next week as Before the Federation starts to wind down and we discuss and theorize a bit about the Earth-Romulan War. Hey guys, this Sunday at 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, I will be doing another partnership with Perfect World and playing Star Trek Online. Please come out if you can and support the channel. There will be giveaways and we'll be talking everything Trek. Even if you don't like Star Trek Online, supporting me during partnerships is integral to keeping this channel alive, so I appreciate anything you can do. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, and guys, I'll see you on the next Lore Reloaded.